जय आर्यवत।
जय आर्यवत। मेरा सौभाग्य है कि
मैं रथ की यात्रा के लिए तैयार हूँ।
धीरे धीरे
जिए आर्यवत के लिए, मरे आर्यवत।
Hi Siddharth, welcome to the Quint.
Thank you.
We are on the sets of Leila, and we know that it's a series that's set in the future. You've been shooting in Old Delhi and parts of Noida. Give us a feel of what the setting of this world is.
I think primarily it's best to clarify what they're addressing as dystopia in this. There's no science fiction. It's not a period piece in that sense where you're going by the technology of the time. I think identifying our present day itself as a dystopian society where things are what they are with very specific restrictions of what one can and cannot do. So it's set in a distant, not so distant future where similar restrictions exist, where you can and cannot do certain things. So it's about the universe that it's set in and setting a human story against that universe. And I think that makes it exciting because you have the larger socio-political climate against which the show is set. But what's more important and what's going to take you through the entire season is the human interaction and the interplay between the people that have been established in this climate.
Given that the world that we are living in right now, actually, do you think that it's not so futuristic or not so unrealistic to think about a world like that? I mean, seeing the ghettoization that we are seeing around us already.
So I believe the future of not just this country, but any society is going to hold on to certain things that exist right now. And so I don't think today's political climate is chalk and cheese different from 10 years ago. I'm not from that school of thought. I do believe that there's always going to be the haves and the have-nots. And for as long as those two categories exist, you're in dystopia, right? So this is about heightening that have and have-not situation. So in this case, it's a divide based on purity. And so those that are considered pure and those that are considered not. So that's what creates the conflict in the universe. So it's easy to argue that, yeah, it's like that today. But by that definition, no future can be that different that it has nothing to do with the present we live in today. So yeah, while I do agree, I would say it's an exaggerated version of certain things that exist in society today. But more than that, it becomes unique because it has its specific rules and regulations, its rights and wrongs. And that's what makes that world unique.
How different was the experience of working on a series? I mean, compared to a two-hour film that you produce at the end of, let's say, 30 or 40 days of shoot?
I think the interesting way to approach this is it's based on a book, right? So any book that's adapted to screen, generally the difference in film format is it's 2.5 hours. So you can take a little bit of the essence of the book and then you make it screen friendly and you make it into a screenplay. In this case, the duration is a bit longer, but more importantly, how the audience consumes it is completely different. So when you make a film, you are talking to a captive audience, an audience that's paying money to sit in a space and be given content. In this case, you're giving them a little more democracy. They can watch it maybe in fits and starts of 10, 20 minutes, 30 minutes at a stretch, or they can do the classic binge watch and watch all of it together. So it's very difficult to factor those things while approaching the meter of the performance. But having said that, once it's camera rolling, there's no difference really, because you're performing a character and the camera is rolling. So it's about micro and macro. So on a macro level, a lot of things are different. But on a micro level, when you're addressing the scene or the shot, it's pretty much the same as any other job.
But you're also working with three different directors on this one script. How has that experience been? Do they have different approaches or do you have to wire yourself differently when you're working with...
It's very complicated, to be honest with you, in the sense that I expected it to be far more challenging than it was. So I've worked with three different filmmakers, each of them very unique in their own right. I can tell you they're all completely different from each other in the way they directed us, but they're still directing the same characters. So that was really interesting because I feel at the end of it that we were directed by one person. And that's something that both the format and the nature of this script kind of leads to that result. It's been incredibly satisfying because we inherited each director, or let's say the directors inherited us. So Deepa Mehta started off, I worked with her before, and on a feature no less. And she has a very specific rhythm and she runs a set a certain way. And we identified and understood the foundations of our characters under her. And then we were passed on to the next director. And he inherited the set as it was. And then further to from Shankar to Pavan. And Shankar is a Zen master. The way he operates on set he's also a DOP and so he's a technician. And he runs the set in a certain way. And Pavan is very indie and has a different set of ideas to work with. But what is common was two things. One was the script. And the second was the DOP. So he was also inherited as part of the parcel, right? And I think he was my biggest takeaway from this show, because I've worked with some of India's top cinematographical talents, and watching this young guy from abroad come and shoot India the way he's shot it really gives it a different edge. So I think I'd say it's very satisfying to work with three directors, almost to the point that I'm starting to think, should I get three directors for my next feature film? But then I know how crazy complicated that would be. And so yeah, that was the most unique part, to be working with three completely different talents on the same content.
Okay, great. Thanks. Lovely talking to you.
Cheers.